Mr. Larsen, we'll begin with you.
Thank you, Mr. Chair and Ranking Member, for the opportunity to testify today. It's a little bit different being on this side of the dais after 22 years on the committee. I welcome you to come testify before the Transportation Committee at any time. And we'll treat you as nicely as you will treat me later after I'm done with my testimony.
Absolutely.
Although I won't participate in the committee markup of this year's NDAA, I will take the next few minutes to highlight some of the priorities that are important to the district that I represent. So in communities surrounding military installations, jet noise from flight operations is a frequent concern. And in previous NDAAs, I've secured funding for jet noise reduction research. In my district, the sailors at Naval Air Station Whidbey Island are working to reduce the impact of flight operations on surrounding communities. So I just request that the committee continue to require the Navy to support this research and provide a report and briefing on the status of this research. Second, the Bipartisan Electromagnetic Warfare Working Group, or EW Working Group, works to promote electromagnetic warfare systems and raise awareness of the importance of EW in the national defense strategy. And last year's NDA included my request for an updated EW force structure. And it is important that the DOD deliver on this report. It is not yet delivered on that report. And I would hope the committee presses the department to do just that. America's women and men in uniform sacrifice greatly as well. They should not have to sacrifice, however, their dreams of having a family. I've met with veterans and service members who struggle with having children due to medical complications because of their service in the military. And establishing a pilot program to cryopreserve gametes prior to training and deployments would enable service members to choose to have a family should a dramatic injury occur. And I'd ask that all members support this effort to help our veterans and service members start a family. Last year, on the committee, I asked General Milley how the DOD is integrating AI education into professional military education. His response revealed that the DOD has work to do to ensure that junior officers and the enlisted ranks have access to AI education. And I request the committee require the DOD to establish an AI education program for all ranks, officers and enlisted, to ensure service members understand AI concepts and ethics and have the tools they need to solve problems and create efficiency through the use of artificial intelligence. Now, as a member of the NATO Parliamentary Assembly as well, I'm a strong supporter of NATO's efforts on the Defense Innovation Accelerator for the North Atlantic, or the DIANA program. DIANA will enable NATO allies to adopt and integrate innovative technologies. In last year's NDAA, I requested funding for DIANA and pushed for the DOD to select a U.S. representative to the DIANA board. I am pleased that Ms. Barbara McQuiston was elected to chair the DIANA Board of Directors and that the Pacific Northwest Mission Acceleration Center in Seattle was selected as the second DIANA site in the United States. And I asked the committee to support emerging technology and NATO by continuing to invest in DIANA. Two final issues. The DOD recognizes financial readiness as a crucial component of not only service members' lives, but the lives of their families and more specifically their children. Financial literacy education in the Department of Defense Education Activity Schools is critical to prepare military children for the future. And I ask the committee to include a provision in the NDAA requiring DODEA schools to add a financial literacy course in their high school graduation requirement. And finally, on the Constellation Class Frigate program, they will protect U.S. interests. The Navy's also selected Everett, Washington as their first home port. And I hope that the committee can continue to support reliable, predictable shipbuilding schedule and funding to prepare for the frigate's scheduled arrival in 2026. And with that, I'd like to thank you for taking time to consider my priorities for this year's NDAA.
Mr. Larsen, thank you. And the issue of shipbuilding, obviously, is going to be front and center. Thanks so much for your advocacy, for timeliness of pending reports. We know how incredibly important that is for us to make our decisions in making sure we're helping service members and their families with having families. That, too, is important for quality of life, as well as issues on artificial intelligence and the NATO accelerator, as well as financial literacy. So thanks so much for all of your issues that you brought before us. And as always, we will do all that we can to accommodate you in every way possible. So thanks again. Thank you.